This lesson is on dividing polynomials, and we're going to learn to use long division. So the division algorithm says if you have a polynomial, p of x, it equals the divisor times the quotient plus the remainder. So I'll explain that once we get through an example. So if you want to divide polynomials, for example, if you want to divide 6x squared minus 26x plus 12 by x minus 4, you are going to make sure that these are in descending order. Okay, so then you're going to put x minus 4, this is what you're dividing by, outside the box, and 6x squared minus 26x, it's in descending order, they're both in descending order, plus 12 inside the box. And this x minus 4, that's the divisor. So that's this d of x. This 6x squared minus 26 plus 12, that's called the dividend. And that's what you started with. That's p of x. That's the beginning polynomial. And you're going to divide. So before we divide, I just want to remind you how we divide normally. If we just divide with numbers, you take this divisor 4 and you divide it into just this first number here, 7, and 4 goes into 7 one time and you write it up there. And then do you remember you multiply? So 1 times 4 is 4, and then you draw your line and then you subtract. So 7 minus 4 is 3, and then you remember what you do, you bring that 9 down and then you do it again. And so 4 goes into 39 9 times, and then again you multiply. 4 times 9 is 36, and you draw your line and change the sign, or you subtract and you get a remainder of 3. And sometimes you just wrote R3, and sometimes you wrote the remainder over the divisor, 19 and 3/4. So really that's what we're going to do here, with a couple of changes obviously because we have variables. But what you're going to do is you're going to use this leading term x, and you're going to divide with that. So 6x squared divided by x, okay, 6x squared divided by x is 6, and then x squared divided by x is the one you subtract, so that's 6x. And then like you did here, you're going to multiply. But here's where something's a little different. You've got to make sure you multiply that 6x to both of those terms. You've got to get the minus 4 involved. Okay, so 6x times x is 6x squared, and 6x times negative 4 is negative 24x. Okay, and this is always going to be the same. All right, now remember the next thing you did was you subtracted, and I kind of said it on purpose. I drew my line and I subtracted because I like students to remember this. I like to say draw your line and change the signs, because I don't want this subtraction to be way out here belonging to both of those terms. So I like to distribute the minus. Subtraction is the same as adding the opposite. So I'm going to draw my line and change these signs. The opposite of 6 is negative 6. And the opposite of negative 24 is positive 24. So what I basically did was I distributed that minus and made it a plus. So I say draw your line, change the signs. Then you can use the adding rules. 6x squared plus a negative 6x squared cancels to 0. Negative 26x plus 24x is negative 2x. And then you bring down everything left. There's only one term left, but if there were more than one term left, just bring down everything so you never have to look up here again. And you have a new expression underneath the line and you start over. So then negative 2x divided by x is negative 2. And then you multiply, make sure you multiply both of these. So negative 2 times x is negative 2x. Negative 2 times negative 4 is positive 8. Okay, and after you multiply, you're going to draw your line and change the sign. What you're doing is distributing the minus. So draw your line, change that negative to a positive, change that positive 8 to a negative, and now you can use your adding rules. Negative 2x plus 2x, gone. 12 plus a negative 8 is 4. Now, how do you know when you're done? Well, you're dividing by a degree 1 polynomial. And once your remainder gets to be lower than that, this is a degree 0. Constants, I think I've not said this before, but constants are not degree 1. Constants are degree 0 because 4x to the 0 is what 4 is. Anything to the 0 power is 1. So a constant is actually degree 0. So once your degree is lower than what you're dividing by, then you know that's your remainder. Okay, so this is the remainder. And finally, this answer up here is your quotient. So the division algorithm says that if you have 6x squared minus 26x plus 12, that polynomial, it's equal to the divisor, x minus 4, times the quotient, 6x minus 2, plus the remainder. That means if we were to multiply this out, which I will really quickly, 6x squared minus 2x minus 24x plus 8 plus 4, I'm going to get what I started with, and I am. I did the arithmetic too early. Plus 8 plus 4 is 12. Okay, so that's the division algorithm. The polynomial is equal to the divisor times the quotient plus the remainder. Okay, so you may have to express that. The answer, you may just have to fill in the blank. Okay, this is the quotient, this is the remainder. Or you may have to say this is the answer. 6x minus 2 plus the remainder 4 over what you divide it by, which is kind of like what is going on when you say this answer is 19 and 3/4. So it just depends on the way that we ask it. All right, let's try another one. Make sure you're in descending order. 3x to the 4th minus 2x plus 1. You're going to divide that by x squared minus x minus 3. Okay, so this is my divisor. It's going to go in on the outside. This is my dividend, 3x to the 4th minus 2x plus 1. Now, I teach it differently than some teachers do. Notice that there are terms missing. It goes from x to the 4th to x. There's a x cubed term missing, 0x cubed. There is a x squared term, 0x squared, and some teachers teach you to write that in there. I just don't like doing that. I just like to say, notice that you're skipping some terms, and then we're going to deal with it. All right. Okay, but we're in descending order, so again, we're going to divide with this x squared. So 3x to the 4th divided by x squared is 3x to the 2. Because 4 take away 2 is 2. And then we're going to distribute that 3x squared back to all three of those. Okay, so 3x squared times x squared is 3x to the 4th. And then 3x squared times negative x is negative 3x to the 3rd. And then 3x squared times negative 3 is negative 9x squared. Okay. And then you're going to subtract, which we do, draw your line and change the sign. That means we're going to change subtraction to adding the opposite. So change all the signs. That's going to become a negative. That's going to become a positive. That's going to become a positive. All right, now here's where I differ. I don't need placeholders because I knew it was going to happen, and now it's happened. So you can see that when you line things up, you see how these aren't like terms? Okay. So you can't add things together that aren't like terms, and you've known that. So I'm going to trust that you won't do that. Okay, so 3x to the 4th and a negative 3x to the 4th, that's gone. And then you just want to make sure you write down your terms in descending order. How many terms do you see? 1, 2, 3, 4. And none of them are like terms, so don't add them together. I don't find that students have that issue, so I don't think that's necessary. It makes the problem a lot longer. Okay, so we're going to write down these four terms, we're adding these forms together and terms together, and we're going to just write them in descending order. So the highest exponent is what goes first, 3x cubed. And then next would be 9x squared. And then next would be negative 2x. And then next would be plus 1. And you just add everything underneath the line, and you'll never have to look up here again. Okay. And now the problem is gone. Okay, so now it's, once you get under the line, you're going to start over. 3x cubed divided by x squared. 3x cubed divided by x squared. That's going to be 3. And then x cubed divided by x squared is x to the 1. So now I have to distribute that to all of these three terms. So that's 3x cubed minus 3x squared minus 9x. Draw your line and change the sign. All right, make sure you only add like terms together. These are like terms and they cancel. Okay, this is a 9x squared plus a 3x squared. They're like terms, that's 12x squared. We have a negative 2x and a positive 9x. These are different signs. So when the signs are different, you subtract and take the sign of the larger number. So that's going to be positive 7x, and then bring down that plus 1, bring down everything. So now you never have to look up here again. All right, now we're going to do it again. 12x squared divided by 3x squared. All right, so these x squareds cancel. This is just going to be 4. 12x squared divided by 3x, but I'm not sure where I got 3x squared. Sorry, messed up. 12x squared is being divided by x squared, so that's going to be 12. Alright, now I would have caught my error here, because now I'm going to multiply this 12 to these three terms, and you should always get the same exact term right here, 12x squared minus 12x minus 36. Draw your line and change the sign. We are subtracting, but I'm distributing that minus to these three. So that's a negative, that's a positive, that's a positive. Draw your line and change the signs. Then these add to 0, which they should. 7 plus 12 is 19x, and then you have 37. Now, am I done? Well, this is degree 2, and this is degree 1. So you can't do any more dividing. This degree is smaller than that, so you're done. So this is my quotient. And this is my remainder. All right. Last one. Let f of x equal 2x cubed minus 7x squared plus 5. And g of x equal x minus 3. And we're going back to unit 2. Find f of x divided by g of x, f over g of x. Well, that means you're going to take this function and divide by that function. And it says write your new function in the following way, quotient plus remainder over divisor. So you have to know that means, hey, they want me to divide. Okay, so even if it's written differently or worded differently, how do you divide a polynomial by this binomial? We just did it. It's written differently, but you have to put the divisor outside and then the dividend inside. And again, while you're writing it down, make a note, you're missing a term. You're missing the x term. It goes from x cubed to x squared and skips over the x term. So I'm not going to write 0x, but I am going to be aware that eventually do not add unlike terms. Okay, so let's do this. 2x cubed divided by x is 2x squared. Okay, then you multiply that out, so that's 2x cubed minus 6x squared, and you draw your line and change the sign. They add to 0. Negative 7x squared and 6x squared, they're like terms, so the problem hasn't happened yet, and you have to make sure you don't lose a negative. This is going to end up being a negative 1x squared, and then bring down your plus 5. Okay, underline, you start over. Negative 1x squared divided by x is negative 1x. Now you're going to multiply back out, so that's negative 1x squared. And then negative 1x times negative 3 is positive 3x. Draw your line, change the signs. Now look very carefully. These are like terms, they cancel, but are these like terms? They are not. So write them down in descending order. Just write these two terms, they're vertically right now, just write them horizontally in descending order. Negative 3x plus 5, can't add them together. Now we're going to divide one more time. Negative 3x divided by x is negative 3. Now we're going to multiply that back out. That's negative 3x. And then negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9. Draw your line and change the signs. They add to 0, they add to negative 4. Degree 1 is what your divisor is. Degree 0 is what your remainder is, so you're done. Okay, then it says write the new function in the following way. So we just did this. This is f over g of x. In unit 2, we ended it right there. We just wrote it that way. But this time they want you to write it this way. What is the result when you divide the x minus 3 into that? Well, you get this quotient, 2x squared minus 1x minus 3. Plus the remainder, which is negative 4, over what you divided by x minus 3. And that's the result. That's what f over g is.